Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We're in the Esternwood. Blah. And we'll explore all this area, and we're going to clear off the map some more. I'm assuming this way is towards the... What's the guy's name? Radric? Lord Radric's hold. But, of course, we're going to explore the entire map, as we always do, and clear out all the fog of war, which is always very satisfying to me.
Got it.
Got it. Now, there's a gap somewhere over here, right? In this fence. Which stands in our way. How dare this thing. Whoop! We got more of those wicked things, which are like savage kind of... I don't know, they kind of look like children. I'm not sure if they are children or what. I don't know, they're humans that have no souls or something like that. And they're, you know, they're pretty easy to kill, but they never are alone. So there's bound to be, like, at least four more of them.
Eh?
Knock your arrows. Alright, one down. That's the way I like it. Killing them before they even get to us, which is... I approve of that. I approve. Well. Have our warrior types just wade into battle the way they do. We do knockdowns, because... Oh. What the hell's going on? I'm clicking on the others. Knockdown. Whoever gets to do it first. Knockdown. It's bound to be enjoyable. Amplified thrust off of our man-eater. Have him wait for a minute. Holy Radiance. And go!
Not believe.
Oh, look at those chunks! Ah. Here I said at least four, and there was only three of them, right? Or that vessel flesh that they all have. So they're just... Mm-hmm. They're vessels only. They,
Keeping quiet. No problem.
They're empty shells. More of that skein bone stuff. I believe we have some of that. Oh, we're over in the middle. For some reason I thought we were near the edge. I can't seem to go any further than that. I really want to clear... I wasn't aware this thing was in the way. I kind of want to just clear out the western portion here. Excuse me. These carvings glisten with fresh sap. Are we hungry for that sort of thing right now? No, we're still not. Near the edge here. That's the edge. Okay, so we can go over this. There's more of this stuff. What kind of stuff? Golden celery. Wow, we haven't seen that before. More of nothing here. Wait, no, here. A common sight on deer wood and farmland, these thick-stemmed plants are topped by clusters of small yellow flowers. They are commonly used for cooking or the creation of gold rot chew, derived from their roots. That's very popular chewing gum around these parts. Actually, no, that's not what it is, but... Anything else to see here? I don't want console command. I wonder what console commands are available, actually. Can we do, like, no clipping and go through things? I'm sure there's a god mode. I'm not gonna use that, guys, but... I'm just curious. Well, we are stuck here. What the hell is all this? You know? Yeah, put all this crap in our way. You've probably looked at that already. Alright, this is like another road? Now I've seen that, I'm sure. Maybe this is the way to Radric's Hold. Guess I keep hitting the tab key to see if there's anything selectable here. Ooh, gates. Cemetery gates. Oh, this is a cemetery. Human skeleton. Oh, it's a cemetery. Alright. I like how they put human skeleton as if to differentiate from, I'm supposing, all the other skeletons we'll find in this game. We haven't encountered any skeletons yet, so this is pretty cool. I always find killing skeletons to be very satisfying. Of course, our piercing weapons are going to do probably half damage or maybe no damage. I'm sure arrows are going to do much better, but...
Hmm.
We really want some blunt weapons for something like this. Seven pierce... Huh, okay. Nice. See, we can do pierce damage. 21... Ooh. You know, I never noticed that. That's what we rolled? Look at that. We've got all our stats right here.
Sweet.
I did not know this. 40-something episodes in, and I just noticed that. get to use all this stuff, but... Well, we did get to use the what do you call it? The... Amplified Thrust. Regular sword and shield.
Eh?
Eh? Eh, Sonny?
Shh.
No problem.
Shh. I'm hunting skeletons. Omawa skeleton. See that? I knew it, guys. I knew it. Alrighty, so I bet you this will be a little tougher than the other.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay, we've also got a dwarf skeleton and an Orland skeleton, huh? But the elves are not represented. Oh wait, are Orland's elves? I don't even know. Ooh, we laid low that Omawa. That's nice. I literally don't know why I selected all of them, because... Ah, excuse me. I got a dry throat here. Ginger ale. Yum. All right, Holy Radiance for what ails you? Necrotic Lance probably wouldn't do much. Might even heal them. Let's see if we can take out this Orlan skeleton with a Minor Letters magic missile, whatever the hell. And once again, I'm getting bored, boring with this, but I just love this combo, the Amplified Thruster from Eater.
Luckily.
Nice. Alright, we're alright. Everyone hit this. A pike. Have we ever found a pike before? Well, it's a two-handed weapon, obviously. Very slow. It's good for reach, but not much else. Pikes are easily the longest weapons in common use by soldiers and adventurers in the Deerwood. Powerful two-handed piercing weapons, the main advantage pikes have is their long reach, which allows wielders to attack enemies from behind their allies. Correct, correct. I don't want to compare, thank you very much, though. I wanted to put that into the stash. What'd I do? That.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea.
I've heard this story before.
Which is not very quiet.
Yeah. Oh, here's all the
graves.
They
probably got one dug for me, too. Probably gave me a nice spot.
Many of these are quite recent. Someone's been busy.
A great many of these people died just this past year. Not of plague, I think.
I say the Aethasian leads the way.
They all got something to say, don't they? And, finding out that Eater is just a little bit pessimistic, huh? I think about... Well, that's interesting, though. I wonder if the back way is going to be somewhere up here. Oh, wait, we got more stuff. A poleaxe. The versatile poleaxe is a powerful and flexible weapon that can deal devastating blows even against a fully armored opponent. Its straight bladed axe head is opposed by a hammer, allowing the wielder to switch between different damage types as circumstances require. Well, it's pretty good, so as to deal blunt damage to skeletons, stuff like that. And a sword and a medium shield. Oh, we go off the map here. There's got to be something to look at here. Yeah, it says here. It's got a strange icon on it. Oh, memorials, huh? Blackthorn's Ode to the Fallen. What do we get to choose here? Lorem Ipsum is simply dummy text of the printing and typesetting industry. Lorem Ipsum has been the industry standard dummy text, ever since the 1500s, where an unknown printer took a galley of type and scrambled it to make a type specimen book. It has survived not only five centuries, but also the leap into electronic typesetting. What? They're trolling me now. Puff the Swamp Dragon. Here lies a proof that wit can never be defense enough against a sword. I thought they were going to tell me about Puff the Magic Dragon who lived in a swamp or something. Blackthorn's Ode to the Fallen. Here's to the Fallen of Sorcerer's Place. Sir Bell, a paladin with sword and mace. Takara was Turnips, put a smile on his face. Kitrax for Tech. Help was first on the case. Each one now gone, but not without trace. You know, I bet the backers, the Kickstarter backers, you know, those people who, like, put in 500 bucks or something, they get to write this stuff. Hlin should have kept one of the kidneys. James Quirzimian Paul. A warrior from another land fighting against his own body for the right to live. He fought 25 years to be felled in his greatest battle. He lived through worse than this. Keepers of the Core. It is improvident to regard something as a trifle just because it fails to catch the eye. One should never judge a book by its cover, or one may miss at least one marvel. Look deeper, wayfarer. Don't tell me what to do. Anton. Enjoy, because I sure will. These are Kickstarter backer messages, guys. There's not too much more. Some of them are short, so let's go ahead. Samuel Schwager. A life spent making mistakes is not only more honorable, but more useful than a life spent doing nothing. Okay. Alliance Wolf. In memory of my best friend, Ratman. May us always remember him. Okay, I'm not even going to go there with the grammar. Mario. Lived and died by the dice. Craig Nightclaw White. Not everybody appreciate those who lend a helping hand. Okay. A name? Fihi ma fihi. Whom in do you search long and hard and dedicated your life? I hope you have found in it what is in it. Sorry, guys. This is just comical. Anders Deuce. In memory of ISAF 14. Krzysztof Ansermancer Kupka. An Ansermancer proves a dubious addition to any adventuring party, being mostly useless in the thick of battle and largely only good for his knowledge of obscure trivia. Fun in a pub, though. Actually, I like that one. Aoyagi Aichu. Bless you. A life has been wasted on searching for a place inhabited by wise people skilled in the ancient and forgotten art of grammar. Capitalization, punctuation, syntax, spelling, no hope, all is lost. From some of the other entries here, I agree. Camille Hitt, 1994 through 1999, or 2009, sorry. House of Witchmere, acrobat, hunter of butterflies, destroyer of gingerbread houses. Alright. Jorgen Finstad. I am just going outside and maybe some time. A.J. Olesen. To be lost in eternity is to truly find home. May we never lose the spirit and imagination that brought us here. That's pretty cool. Claudia, Suzu, and Neighbor Cat. Three overlords known for their intelligence, laziness, and raw killing power. Is that respectively? Alright. Backer messages. Onward. You can't venture. Oh, there's a rocks, actually. Who's this? We didn't fight him, did we? Oh, there's a door. Dead adventurer. Fine arbalest. Ugh. I don't like the way it's very slow like that. Arbalests are heavy crossbows with exceptionally high power. They must be hand-cranked before loading, so they have a slow rate of fire. Well, thank you for that. Oh no, more messages. My god. Heresy Research Labs. Alright, we're seeing an old message here. Bernhardt. All men must die. But why, oh why, die I have to fry? Bursk Awesome Sauce. Bank of Bursk is now closed. Good to know. dot, 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 or commas, knew too much. Christopher Buckley. If I could reach from pole to pole or grasp the ocean with a span, I would be measured by the soul. The mind's the standard of the man. I like that one. There's a few gems in here. Lucane Morgans. Had too little common ground. Did old Lucane with plebs from Dale to seat a single blade of grass. Still the wizard had me round and would spin me a twisting tale. The lonesome evenings to pass. Alrighty then. Athos Mazanti. The noble father of a grateful son. Cardo, Obsidian Order Risk Assessor. Nothing is achieved without risk. You just have to assess the risks, and your name might still end up on a tombstone. Yeah, eventually. Carlo I. As a denizen of far-off lands as Westgate and Toril, Carlo has dedicated himself to the adventuring life, first by taking the endless road himself, then guiding others along its twisting paths. Well, he's dead now, right? Isn't that the point? Stian Bielvin Schultz. Nothing beats a good old linguistic barrier. Well, arrows, things. Kill the unarmed. He heard its scream as if a dream, but knew not what to fear. He went to sea without his steel. A curious man was Keel. He rolled the dice and paid the price. 'Twas the beast of Irbrantil. Alright, well, this, for some reason we started off here, but there's more up here. Heresy Research Labs. We must move forward. Okay, moving forward. Robert Kingsley. Timshel. Righty, Brave Coast. To my old fellows from Mundo Orb, Sirgon, Cousin, Neki, Droido, Daryl, Longshot, wasn't he an X-Men? Mir, Orphan, Kekko, Chris, those were good times, and ye were best mates. See ya, comrades, Brave Coast and Sabab. Brendan Munson Risbridger. 7. Brish the Harbinger. Brish was a headstrong, loyal, and dedicated person to his companions and loved one. Oftentimes he would take on jobs that were deemed suicidal, thus earning the title of Harbinger. Poor Todd the Bartender, property owner of the Elizabeth Dane, died like a sod at the Battle of Innsmouth. Innsmouth, I think. May his soul rest in peace, covered in slov and filth at the table of drunken Davy Jones' locker. GameBanshee.com. Oh my god, we've got an ad. Thank you to Obsidian Entertainment and the legion of role-playing fans around the world that have helped solidify GameBanshee in the pantheons of internet and video game history. You know, I've barely heard of them, so, whatever. Lucky. Sejit Sire Lucky. Son tier legendaire lu permis de triumphare de tous si adversaires. Helas son non... No. Whatever. Alright, done. I said done? Thank you. That would be bad if I couldn't get out of that. What about here? Is there a secret panel? Of course there is. I'm not going in there yet, though.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Yeah, the flame. What's this? Oh, more. You know, it's wrong here, because... See that? That's the true inscription. Sergei Moravsky. Here lies in earth a root of hell, set by the Dale's Ain Dibel. This worthless body damned himself to save the Lord, the Trebel? Jethro Q. What? I'm not saying that. Founding member of the Society for Collaborating Solipsists. Chippy. This name appears like it was stamped into the memorial from a heavy blow. It is cracked, weather-beaten, barely hanging on, and looks as though it might be dashed with four winds at any moment. Actually, it actually fits the game. Chris Van Darg. Under this black soil lies a man whom the world was too much to live in. After having gone from north to south, east to west, he went underground. Nightshock. Ash Winnie. The best Winnie. My favorite Winnie was Winnie Cooper, and second only to Winnie the Pooh. Nicholas Zukas. All I know is that I know nothing. Clamo. Here, in an eternal state of irony, lies Clamo, coffin dodger of the Obsidian Order. Necrophiliacs apply within. Joshua. And how can man die better than facing fearful odds for the ashes of his fathers in the temples of his gods? Claru. Without everyone help, this memorial won't even be here. Thank you, everyone. Coffee Minx. Sarathiel was here. Visa Tovornen. Decapitated by a mailbox. Ingenium. I can only please one person per day. Today is not your day. Tomorrow doesn't look good either. I've heard that one before. Doris Lanfer. A man of few words. Gobi Freed. Fortune favors the brave, my son. Is that an L? Corlagon, ambassador of the Obsidian Order. In remembrance of those who gave their lives during the Golden Era. Karan Kane. Nothing. Corey Starkiller. In a world where we want is only what we want until it's ours. You sometimes get what is needed, so don't give up hope. It comes from the least expected place. The struggle is worth the effort. Yes. Inspired words from Corey Starkiller. A dream dancer. Who knows where the dance will take the dreamer? Onto a memorial, apparently. I hear whispering in there. Okay, I'm not going in here yet, because I think it's the way out. I'm going to explore the rest of this first. And we got a little bit of time left. Not that much, but we'll be back. And yes, I do remember back hold on. Okay, I can't look at the map. Back where we were, we found Canna. At Cadnua, the dungeon down there. I know I still have to explore that shimmering door. I kind of forgot about it for a bit. Catching up with all our, outstanding enemies. Who are now no longer outstanding. Alright. We shall be back. So yeah, after we finish exploring all this, and the keep and all this stuff, we're going to be heading on to Defiance Bay. I don't know why I can't see the map. So before we head to Defiance Bay and move onward from there, which I'm actually not sure. There must be another way east from where we were. To go around this way. Yeah, I'll check out that door and then we'll move on. Of course, I'm going to want to get all the little odds and ends done before we head to Defiance Bay. Because, basically most or I guess all of my Let's Plays.
I'll see what I can find.
And we'll see what we can find in them. And also, I try to explore everything. Everything. Every quest done, every location explored. So, with that in mind, Oh, see, that bothers me. That bothers me. We'll always have that little spot there. And that spot there. For shame, for shame. Why didn't we not stop? Because we can see that. We should have stopped.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should have.
Hi?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm?
Eh.
Hmm?
Eh.
Hmm?
Yes?
Yes.
Yeah?
Kill this spider that you haven't seen yet for some reason.
After him!
Do you have to yell that like that? Oh boy. Spear spider, spear spider. Okay. How about this one? Alright. They got to us pretty quickly. It's fast little things. Let's kill the spirit of spiderling first. I guess that'll fall quickly. We can get around each other here. What do you call it? Off of Eater. Amplified thrust, right. Can't see, I guess he's behind a tree. Here. That's Kanna. Kanna attacked this one. Firebrand. Yeah. We're kind of stuck together here. Okay. She already cast her spell, so Soul Shock. Is that the one I want? Yeah. Off of Eater again. Oh, he hasn't cast Arcane Assault yet? Okay. Usually does that very quickly. I feel like attacking somehow. Freeze damage. Oh, that's neat. So it helps us and injures them. That's pretty neat. I have never used that. Say we really needed it, but it was interesting to watch. Leg. Alright, I'm sure we're gonna finish off this map next time.
Eh?
So thanks for watching. See you next time, and yeah. Endure. In enduring, grow strong.